Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah.
Dude, no, there's another woman. A woman is claiming she and three friends were refused from an Airbnb booking at the last minute because she's Asian. All right, some girl in the States, a law student from Southern California. This was back in February. She had just a screenshot of the conversation with the Airbnb hostess. And the Airbnb hostess said, if you think four people and two dogs are getting a room for $50 a night on Big Bear Mountain during the busiest week of the year, you're insanely high. And she's like, what do you mean? They were like half an hour away from where they had to be. Like this booking, and she goes.
Wait, they've already booked it.
Yeah, they were half an hour away from like the destination, and she just like jerried that she was Asian, and she's just like, "Nah, you're not fucking getting it." And she goes, "This is what she said." She goes, "Oh, this is fucked." She goes, "The girl said to the host she planned to report her to the Airbnb officials for being racist and like doing something illegal," and she said, "It's why we have Trump."
Ooh, and cold.
And she added, I will not allow this country to be told what to do by foreigners. This girl had moved to America when she was three, and she'd been an American citizen for over two decades.
Yeah, not a foreigner.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you're not a foreigner. Because she literally says one word says it all. Oh, because what she said was, when she said she was cancelling it, she goes, she wouldn't rent it to her if she was the last person on earth. One word says it all, Asian. And she's like, I'm going to report you. She goes, well, that's why we have Trump. This idiot fucking redneck somewhere in California is like, oh, yeah, our president's going to stop foreigners doing whatever they want. It's like, I've been in the country for 20 years.
So she's only cancelled it once she's jerried that she's Asian.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, 30 minutes or whatever from
Well, the last name Zhao didn't, like, ring a bell?
When you made the booking, didn't Zhao ring any bells?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why we have Trump.
That's fucked up.
How fucked up is that?
Well, there's the mentality.
So why would you assume, wouldn't you assume that like some head-hotted fucking idiot United Airlines workers, security guards, air marshals, whatever, have the same fucking attitude?
Yeah, good point.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Because she's Asian, she's clearly a foreigner. Dude, she'd been there since she was 3 years old. How's she a foreigner?
Yeah.
No. Foreigner knows more about America than you do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
exactly. I've got friends, man. I remember like that Indian bloke that I used to work with, the one that I taught how to speak English back, like, you know, at my, old job.
Raj.
No, he's not Raj. You fucking racist.
I'm trying to prove a point.
Raj. No. He had a little girl when he got here. Like, after he landed his full-time job and he got into a property, his first thing was to have a kid, and he did. So, like, I remember him coming to work with Sweets one day. It's because his little girl was born, and his little girl is, by default, an Australian citizen.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah. Like, Australian citizen.
She's Australian.
Yeah.
She just is.
Just is. Man, I run into...
She's Australian with Indian heritage.
Yeah, exactly. Like, when she grows up, she'll probably have a fucking ocker accent, like, bad.
Yeah.
How often do you run into, like, people now, like, especially our generation, you run into people our age and stuff, and they clearly have some other cultural ethnicity or whatever, or heritage, you know, whether they're South Asian or, like, Indian or whatever, right? But they have, like, full bogan accents because they were born here. They've been here.
Dude, I see it every day.
I wasn't even born here.
Exactly.
I didn't know English until I was six.
Yeah.
And I'm probably the fucking Aussiest
freak you would get.
Yeah, yeah.
Your life revolves around, you know, footy and fucking...
And meat pies, man. Yeah. I love meat pies.
Beers and...
Oh, dude.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
That's my... Why? Because I'm Australian.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
I consider myself Australian.
People are going to... Like, that's the kind of racist backlash you're going to be copping now, man. Like, fucking people...
Greek heart.
So, speaking of fucking cool Asians, I read that Jackie Chan, the Beauty and the Beast, the Chinese version of it, Jackie Chan did all the overdubbing for the Beast, and he also sang all the shit in Mandarin as well.
Fuck off. Are you
serious? There is nothing Jackie Chan can't do.
I need to see that.
Jackie Chan's a boss, man.
Jackie Chan!
So could you imagine doing, like, a full Jackie Chan version of Beauty and the Beast?
Yeah, man.
He just comes out and, like, fly kicks the dad.
Like, Beauty and the Wang.
Beauty and the Wang. Fuck. This is the most racist thing we've ever done ever, man.
Hey, we love Asians.
Man,
actually, I had Chinese yesterday. It was really nice. We got Chinese takeaway.
Actual Chinese?
Thai's my favorite Asian flavor.
Okay. I get proper, like,
Thai. I'm over Thai.
We had Thai probably like 3 weeks ago. It made me feel sick a bit. And you know what? It was too fusion, man. It was too, like, the authenticity of the food now is gone.
Oh, no. Everything's fusion. Everywhere you go is fusion. Like, I'm not a fan of fusion.
Yeah, we go to this little Chinese place where it hasn't changed since the 60s, man. Like, full, like...
Yeah, it's got that Asian writing on the...
Yeah.
You know that Chinese restaurant?
Yeah, but you'd be lucky that you'd find an English menu in there. Yeah. That's what I love, because it's like full authentic, man.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. You know, like,
you're talking to me. I live next to Springvale.
Chicken and sweet corn soup.
I go for pho, and it's literally
even black bean sauce.
Bullshit.
Yeah, that's why I love going to Richmond for pho.
Exactly.
Because it's authentic.
Yeah, because it's like spring. It's exactly the same.
Pho.
I had pho last week. Yeah. Week ago? I think it was a week ago.
Big healthy you talking dose. About?
The big healthy dose of MSG.
Hey, pho's great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
I was just saying.
Just makes me sweat and go a bit itchy, but yeah, it's good.
Did the last couple of days.
Did you drag your ass against the carpet? No. Like, it's got worms.
Doesn't have pork in it, mate.
Worms. Anyone that doesn't know Johnny, like, would literally just be picturing some fucking rat.
With his legs up over his head, dragging his ass against the carpet.
Scurvy, fucking, what's it called? What's the hives? Like, hives.
Just glowing. This guy's glowing. Dude, he's got better skin than everyone.
All the pamper kits and pamper days.
And the lavender.
I do have very soft, supple skin, right?
Actually, that reminds me. I was going to ask you. I don't think I've ever asked you this.
Very sensitive skin as well, may I add.
So speaking of your home...
A bit of pollen and it flares up.
Speaking of your home grooming...
It's like Sleeping Beauty skin, porcelain. Just to go full circle on
very
that.
Very fragile.
Dude, let me ask you a question. Speaking of Sleeping Beauty...
Like, if I sleep on a pee, ooh...
Speaking of pee, he literally like, ah!
Yeah, dude.
His shoulder pops out.
Bruce.
From a pee. Dude, it's like him playing tennis and complaining about the bug.
His arm falls out.
He's got a kink in his neck. What happened?
I had my first serve and I wasn't feeling right and
he
I knew it.
He sleeps on a pee. Why would there be a pee in your bed?
I was referring to that fairy tale.
Which fairy tale?
The one where, like, she has such soft, delicate skin. If she sleeps on a pee, it, like, bruises her.
Someone search this, please. Who the hell?
What fairy tale is that?
How do you guys not know this?
We're Greek, man. We don't know this shit.
You know your fairy tales. Come on.
Who sleeps on a pee?
So what is she? Just a princess, or is it a...
Yeah. What would you type? I hope I'm not just fully imagining this.
I reckon you probably are.
If I am, I'm...
Oh, my God, there it is. Princess sleeps on a pee. The princess and the pea. That's what it's called.
The princess and the princess.
Full circle.
So I'm like the prince and the pea.
Oh my God, how many mattresses does this bitch have, man?
Yeah. Yeah, even throughout
you know,
all
that. That looks like my neighborhood on fucking Hard Rubbish Day.
Yeah,
man.
Stacking up mattresses.
Yeah.
I think the story is, like, even though she sleeps on that many mattresses, the pea right at the bottom will still damage her skin because it's that perfect.
Then why don't they remove the pea?
Maybe she's just anemic.
Anemic?
She's a princess.
So what's the point of it? Why does she have to sleep on the pee?
I don't know.
Can you read the story?
So it says here...
How the hell did we go full circle back to fairy tales? We're talking about Trump and Tomahawk missiles.
How delicate I am. And I said I'm like the princess and the pee.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Dumbass. All right. It's a... I didn't get it, man. Wait a second.
What's the actual
publication
story?
Date? 1835.
I'm going old school with this one.
Danish.
Boys.
It's Danish. Princess on the pea is literally
a fairy tale. I went to do a Danish accent. Then, but
by Hans Christian Andersen.
Ah, Hans.
About a young woman whose royal identity is established by a test of her physical sensitivity. She's a little shit.
Delicate
little pampered shit, basically.
Yeah. Delicate bitch.
The tale was first published, blah, blah, blah. The plot, yeah.
Blah, blah, blah.
The story tells of a prince who wants to marry a princess, obviously.
Oh, really?
But he's having difficulty finding a suitable wife. Something is always wrong with those he meets. One stinks, one whatever.
One's got shit mother-in-law. Yeah. They're like, bah.
One's got scuff marks on her fucking undies.
What's in here?
One's got scurvy.
Imagine the screening process of this prince. He's just in there having a durry, just like running out of arm. Just Tinder swipes, man.
Spread her legs.
Just swiping.
Show me her fanny.
And he cannot be certain they are real princesses because they have bad table manners. They're too fat or thin or not beautiful. This is in the plot.
Mm.
right? Mm. One stormy night, a young woman drenched with rage. Six shouts.
We did the bird noise in the playtime.
She seeks shelter in the prince's castle. She claims to be a princess, so the prince's mother decides to test this unexpected, unwitting guest by placing a pea in the bed she's offered for the night, covered by 20 mattresses and 20 feather beds.
Yeah.
These bitches serious, man? Where the fuck can they afford that shit, man? All right.
Fantastic furniture's gonna sale.
Bevmar- hey, what is it with the shout out to Bevmarks. Denise, have you listening? In the morning, the guest tells the host that she endured a sleepless night, kept awake by something hard in her bed. Yeah. Pretty sure it wasn't the pee.
That was the prince.
Pretty sure it was the prince.
Fucking hanging out to get some.
Yeah, man. Kept smacking her in the head with it like it's pitch black. prince rejoices. Only a real princess would have the sensitivity to feel a pee through such a quantity of bedding. So the two are married.
Hence why
the story ends with the pee being placed in a museum, where, according to the storyteller, it can still be seen today, unless someone has removed it. Right. That is what... Unless someone has removed it. God, I hate people, man. Like, come on, man.
Like,
I love it. It's something about a princess and a pee. Princess and the pee.
That's
what it's called.
That's a fucked up story. You know what's a fucked up story?
I remember reading that when I was
little. Dude, Mary Poppins. Oh. Mary Poppins. Have you actually looked at Mary Poppins objectively? Like, actually studied it?
Is she a jailbird?
Dude, I grew up watching
that movie.
I never watched the movie because I don't really like musicals.
Or Sherry Bobbins.
No.
Sherry Bobbins.
Dude, I grew up watching that movie.
Oh, Sherry.
It was on the same tape as Batman. I'm pretty sure it was on the same tape as Batman. That's
Batman 1?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
So it was a guy from, like, yeah, Mary Poppins to that. Like, yeah. It was one or the other, like something like that. But I looked at that. I remember, like, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, when I was writing those articles, I actually looked at it like, hang on a second. Dude. They get this random bird to come in and look after the kids.
Yeah, so she's a nanny, yep.
Yeah. All the dudes, like her mate, Dick Van Dyke, is a chimney sweep going up people's chimneys, right? Big use of euphemism for sex, yeah? Then...
I'm going up your chimney.
Dude, she does the whole song about a spoonful of... spoonful of sugar or whatever helps the medicine go down.
Yeah,
this big drug illusion.
Yeah.
Yeah, like chloroform in the kids. Yeah.
Put a tab on their tongue.
Yeah, yeah, like... That's it. Then they go to the park... Yeah, where they literally jump into fucking paintings on the ground.
Yeah.
And then when they come out, everything's like saturated green. For me, that's an acid trip.
Dude, Alice in Wonderland is one big acid trip.
Dude, that is LSD and mushies and acid and DMT all in one hit.
Sounds like mushies.
And then, dude, they go to that dude's house and they have a tea party on the ceiling. They start drinking the tea or whatever the fuck it is.
That's pretty fucked up.
And they're fucking floating on the ceiling. They're high as fuck.
So she lures them in with the sugar on the spoon. And sends him into a wacky trip.
Yeah. Dude, wow. I'm not even joking.
Dude, like...
And half the movie, she's flying around with her umbrella.
Yeah.
Because she's on drugs.
Yeah.
Wow.
For me, it's like Mary Poppins was on LSD, like, through the whole movie. She was fucked.
I didn't know that, dude. I just stayed away from it.
I'm not even joking.
I thought it was a starchy
and her only, like, actual friend that she appears to have, like, some sort of more than face value relationship with is the chimney sweep. Who's, like, in on all the songs and shit as well. Just dancing all over town's chimneys and shit. Like the debonair Dick Van Dyke.
That's messed up.
Is that fucked? Am I wrong? Like,
no, you're not wrong.
I just looked up Mary Poppins drugs, and all these memes came up. Mary Poppins, a spoonful of her sugar will help the medicine go down.
Dude, she's on a carousel. Forget the fact that there are bunnies and shit flying all over, like, everywhere, like, all around her. She's on a carousel, you know, the horse carousels, and it comes off the carousel, and she keeps going, and she wins a race. Like, the carousel just goes through the fucking horse race.
What the
fuck? Is that not a drug trip?
That's a drug trip.
That's a massive DMT trip, man.
I've been on one of those trips.
Yeah. See, I don't doubt that, man.
Didn't take a spoon of sugar, though.
Dude, and the old... Mary Poppins is a junkie. That's a badge, man.
It's a badge.
On a pill.
It's a badge.
Oh, it's a badge.
I want that badge, man. Dude.
Is he on drugs?
The old man. The old man at the bank. The father, like the boss, the guy that owns the bank that, you know, her employer works at or whatever. He gets told, he apparently never laughs, yeah? And then he gets told a joke, and he just dies of laughter. He's just off his head.
Dies of laughter.
He dies of laughter.
That's really sinister. That's, ooh.
Yeah. Literally.
Oh, dude. You've got to follow Disney on drugs. Following it. This is amazing.
It's amazing.
Disney on drugs. Wow, man. Wow.
I'm not even joking. Seriously. Look at Mary. You know what? Watch Mary Poppins. Watch it with your little one. You'll die. Like,
I don't think I want to show it to her now.
Watch it coming from that angle.
Yeah.
Which is really weird because through the whole movie, there's like women suffragettes, like, you know, the first women that fought for equal rights in England. And there's all these positive things. Like, it's actually a really good movie. Mm-hmm. I remember the music and the songs and all that sort of shit.
Okay. Funny, funny thing here, Peter Pan, teaching kids that it's okay to do LSD and to leave the house of strangers in tights since 1911.
Maybe this is why we're all fucked up.
Yeah, dude, Peter Pan comes and they fly out the window.
Yeah.
And go to the imaginary world.
With those tights.
But that's what I'm saying, man. At what point do you stop analysing the fucking thing and just take it for as a story? Because we're not over-analysing the Bible. Like, the Bible in itself...
Bible's gospel.
The Bible is fucking gospel. There are snakes and crucifixions and fucked up talking burning bushes and all types of shit. Noah's Ark.
Oh, dude.
Noah's Ark. Two of every animal in a boat.
Fits on some boat that some guy made.
Some guy, Jeff. Jeff's boats.
Jeff the plumber,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah, right, mate. This will see you through this fucking storm. Don't worry. Yo, I had it down at Bonnie Doon last week. It was a fucking roarer.
Trust me.
It's
fine. You need to charge your phone.
Noah's standing there.
Came charged today, Nicholas.
Dude, can you imagine the guy selling the boat to Noah, just the durry and stubby shorts?
Yeah, trust me, mate.
Got me a beaut here.
Yeah, you're fine, mate. Yeah, like, guarantee on the engine, 2-stroke.
I'll give you a 6-month warranty. And if you have any dramas, talk to my wife, Cheryl. She'll get the paperwork and, yeah. Happy boat, my mate.
Where you from, mate?
Happy boat.
Lee and Gather. Yeah, got Barry out there. You can see you through for any services. I'm going away for the week.
Never sees Jeff again.
Yeah, disappears. The ad just goes off the fucking... No, but how come, yeah, we're going into, like, we can sit here and analyse fairy tales and children's stories and all that sort of shit, analyse them till they're fucked and, like, you know...
Which has been lots of fun, may I add.
Yeah, it's been good.
But then, yeah, we let, like, you know, they're over analysing fairy tales, but the Bible happens to fly through... Every fucking
which is
day.
Like, which are, there's like fireworks going off.
There's bombs going off in the city.
Are fireworks or gunshots? No, it's fireworks.
I hope.
Yeah, it's got the after the. Yeah. It's alright. It's fireworks.
It's probably trialing for the Greek church.
Yeah,
church.
We're going to war. We don't.
There's actually a Greek church around the corner from here.
That was dude.
World War III started.
That's World War III.
Where are you
lucky we're in here, boys. Because we've got the fridge and beers and water.
The beers from the dojo.
And I got leftover cake.
Yeah.
We'll be fine.
We're right.
The
we're
one
right.
day we got the fridge working. I didn't get to finish. What I was asking before we fucked off on all the fairy tales and the shit like that, it was tying into the whole bed thing, the bed ritual. I think I was trying to tie in your pampering shit.
Okay. Dude,
pyjamas.
Yes.
I have an inkling, like a sneaky suspicion that you wear...
I wear a nightcap, yes.
Maybe not a nightcap, but you wear pyjamas.
I used to. I don't anymore. Now I just fall asleep in my work clothes, pretty much.
He's like his
Homer. He just lies down and gets back up.
Lately, literally, yes. No joke.
Are you serious? You fall asleep in your work clothes?
But some people can sleep naked, right? A lot of people I know, like, I have to be naked. I hate sleeping naked.
I don't like sleeping naked.
No, I don't like it.
I've explained it to, like women and stuff. Like, we're men. Like, you physically feels uncomfortable to sleep naked.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like, playing sports... I get the idea, like, as a child, I didn't understand it, but as an adult, I understand what the jock strap is for.
Yeah.
Like, secure your shit.
Stop them big balls slapping on the thighs.
You can cause some serious damage, man.
Yeah, totally.
Like, you can cause some serious fucking damage.
Rupture of the testicle, anything.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I was only asking because I can't remember who I was talking to. Pajamas keep coming up. And for some reason, I'm going to throw him under the bus. My cousin used to wear pajamas, like, back when we were kids.
I'm a party.
Yeah, up until, up until a certain age to a point where I thought it was, like, weird. Like, actual pajamas, like, matching shit. And, like, he wasn't the only one. There's a whole bunch of people on you.
Yeah, I never got into pajamas.
Dude, I was like, I stopped wearing pajamas. I never wore pajamas, and the only pajamas I had were, like, a matching tracksuit set, which were of lighter material. Like, they weren't just regular Puma fucking trackies.
Yeah.
They were a lighter material, but they were a set. I stopped wearing them when I was, like, grade 3.
Yeah. I think when I was younger, I used to wear boxer shorts just to bed, like in a t-shirt.
What do you wear now, Trollman?
I want to know. His eyes. I go commando. Oh, I put on my birthday suit.
Stop.
You're fucked.
Nah, like, just t-shirt.
For some reason, I thought of you when this conversation came up.
The pajamas that I remember having were matching up and bottom flannelette, blue tartan.
Jesus. That's what I thought.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah,
I thought it might.
That's what I thought.
And they were button up. Like literally button up buttons. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had them for ages as well, man. I wore them till they were like thin and you could shoot a pea through them pretty much.
Nah, I used to get too hot, man. I couldn't wear pajamas.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
I don't know. I was thinking about it.
What do you wear, Jimmy? Tell me now.
Me?
Pair of jocks.
Pair of jocks. T-shirt. And a t-shirt, if that.
Hey, you totally just missed a Miyagi that fly. He just grabbed a fly out of midair. That was cool.
It's a mozzie, man. It was in my face.
But carry on with what you were wearing. Are they tight?
After Dark with Bobby Preacher. Pillow Talk. It's back.
Pillow Talk.
Welcome to Pillow Talk with Bobby Preacher.
Are they tight-fitting jocks or...
No, I find the oldest pair I have just to, you know, blow your mind. Okay,
to blow your mind.
I was just saying because I think about it now.
Have they got holes in them that I can sneak through?
What the fuck?
Why did I bring this up?
Yeah, you shouldn't have.
I thought you'd be mature enough to handle this. Right,
I'll try.
I'll try and be mature.
I'm talking about PJs, but for some reason that's enough to set you off.
Oh, easy.
You know, it's
easy.
Just pajamas, easy. But you're already like salivating.
My mind just starts going.
I thought about what you said that last time about wondering what guys you work with having sex with their partners.
Mm. I'm like, still do it.
Fantasizing about anyone, but you want to fantasize about the random Bob and Cheryl. You know what I mean?
I just find it interesting.
You're fucked. No. I was just saying it because I was talking about it.
How would he pump? How would he do it?
I know one of the things that I'd mentioned to this cunt's face. He's just cringing, man. He hasn't said a word. He's just like shaking it off.
Yeah. How would Trobin pump?
I was going to say, one thing that had come up in conversation was female friends of mine. I said, dude, doesn't it fucking weird you out that like a grown man would have like matching PJs? Like you're about to get into bed. Yeah.
And he's just buttoning them up. Yeah, Hang on, darling. I'm coming. Just let me do the top button up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. For me...
That's creepy. That's like...
Isn't it like...
Yeah, it's like serial killer material.
But if I was a woman, that would be like a deal breaker, man. Yeah. Like, yeah, I'm going to go home.
That'd dry me up
real quick. Get out of my house.
That'd dry me up real quick if I was a
woman. Seriously.
Yeah.
It's just like... I don't know. There's something, what's the word I'm looking like sterile, like about.
Yeah, man, starchy. Yeah.
Like his mother bought the PJs for him.
Yeah, totally. I'm on the page.
You know what we should do? We should go to David Jones and just hang out in or that Peter Alexander, whatever it's called, that PJ shop.
Yeah.
Just hang out and see the type of heads that walk through. The one time, dude, I'll be honest, the one time I bought PJs in the last decade was I had a pajama party to go to. It was like a 25th birthday or something. And I physically had to go and buy, like, it was like, you rock up in your pajamas. So I said, what are pajamas? Well, what are you sleeping? What, jocks?
Singlet? My holy jocks.
Okay, do you want me to rock up in my jocks and my singlet? Because I will. So I went to Peter Alexander Outlet down at DFO and physically bought a pair of pajamas, like a pair of pants, like $10.
A pair of suave ones by the sound of it. Peter Alexander.
I went to Peter Alexander and they wanted like an arm and a leg for their fucking shit.
Egyptian cotton.
Yeah,
Egyptian.
I'm not paying this. So I ended up going to Bonds and finding some random pair for like $10.
Yeah.
I still remember like pulling, like, dude, the next day, I remember my mum said, she's, what's this? I'm like, yeah, pajama pants. She's, what the fuck?
I'm a pajama boy, mum, don't you know?
Yeah, even my mum was like, are you joking? Like,
yeah, if you're over like 18 and you're still wearing pajamas, there's something seriously wrong going on.
But there's a market for it.
Yeah, obviously.
There's fucking like...
Peter Alexander.
Peter Alexander, David Jones. Like, all these places are selling silk pajamas, like, with the fucking pocket. You know what I mean? Like, full suits.
For women, I can understand. Like, they've got the nice silk night wear.
Oh, dude, all the girls I know wear, like, flanny PJs in the middle of winter because it's freezing. You know what I mean? Like, it's just a comfort thing. You know, you go to, like, your mate's house or something. She's sitting there wearing, like, flanny PJ pants or something in a singlet. Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah, fair enough, whatever. But I'm just talking about dudes that actually put on the outfit before they go to bed.
Yeah, it's part of the night ritual. Nah.
I like taking my clothes off before I go to bed.
to getting dressed to go to bed.
Like, what? That just sounds weird to me, getting dressed to go to bed.
I
like to take my clothes off as opposed to putting more shit on.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's just, give him at his house just a nude stroll from the bathroom to the bed.
Really proud.
Dude, it's a nightly occurrence.
Dragging his feet, even like if he's tired as well. We could be in the living room watching the footy. He's just completely forgotten we're there.
Lots of smoke.
What?
Just scratching himself.
What the fuck was that?
Yeah, I can see that. Dirty trollman.
Dirty trollman.
I can see Dirty trollman doing that. Yes.
Mate, you know what we've slept on? The footy.
Da 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 da.
I had to explain our text messages to like half a dozen people, man, over the last week.
Text messages?
Yeah, like our WhatsApp thread during footy day.
Mm-hmm.
That last 20 minutes, the last 15 minutes of the last quarter. It's always the same.
It's us just like panicking, having a heart attack.
Let's talk about the Carlton game. Come on.
So basically, Carlton are killing it at the moment. Just beat the Dirty Dons.
One and two. You're killing it.
Hey, we're above Sydney, Hawthorn, and North.
Premiership favourites, Blue Boys. 100%.
Oh, lifted his coat.
Saluted.
Saluted. We're one and two.
Premiership favourites.
Can I just say, fuck the Bombers.
What a team to beat, though, for our first win.
And you know what? Someone that actually said, I'm not a Carlton supporter, but I'm so glad Carlton beat them so we can get over this fairy tale bullshit that Bombers are back and this and that. And he goes, up the Baggers. And he was like a Richmond supporter. He goes, thank God, someone beat them.
Huh. Yeah, it had to be us, though.
Just poetic justice.
Essendon,
to Carlton.
This is for you.
Take it in, Don boys. Take it in.
To be fair, man, like, if you watch the game, it was fucking on fire, man.
We laid 110 tackles. It was a club record in the history.
Oh, really?
Of football.
I didn't know
that. 110 tackles. Dude, 110 tackles.
Dude, we were all over it, man.
And our young boys, Wiedering, injured, got knocked out, came back on.
Man, Wiedering's good.
Dude.
Very good.
Doherty. Be our next captain.
The nicest thing I've seen Wiedering do was get in fucking Jordan Lewis's face after he punched out Cripps last week.
Yep.
At the game.
Stood up straight away.
Just, dude, like, Cripps gets dropped, and then Wiedering runs over and just fucking palms him in the back. Lewis drops, and he looks at, just see the look on his face?
Like,
just perplexed, like, what happened?
What happened?
And he sees Wiedering, he's like, sort of buckles a bit, and then Wiedering's just fucking giving him the, don't argue. I'm like, fuck you.
Because he's such a meek-looking dude, Wiedering, isn't he?
Yeah, he's tall, but he's a young-looking kid.
He's only 19. Yeah. And Lewis, you know what, though?
He's got 3 weeks. Lewis got 3 weeks. Yeah.
Fuck him.
Do you see, do you watch that AFL show on Monday nights? Something
like, is it with Gary Lyon?
Gary Lyon, Carlo,
Lloyd, Channel 9.
And that other cunt.
Yeah.
What's his name? He's also on the footy show now.
Hudgy,
is it called Talking Footy?
No. It's some hack show.
Some show, right? But it's Matthew Lloyd, Lyon, Caro, and Hutchie, right?
I said to my head, and I'm going to have to...
And Caro was talking about Lewis, like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, they were talking about all the racist shit that happened. Adelaide versus Port Adelaide, like, that... Like, they marred, like, that game is, like, a landmark game, like, every year. And they marred it with, like, all the racist crap. But then they brought up Jordan Lewis. It's like, dude, you're meant to be, like, a club leader. You just got 3 weeks for punching out a kid in the face.
Yeah.
And then Lloyd tried to defend it.
Of course he did. Sniper.
Yeah, I know. As sad as it is, you think of Lloyd and sniping and all that sort of shit.
It was against Jordan Lewis.
Yeah.
He took out Lewis. He took out Lewis.
He took out Lewis.
That's hilarious.
Full circle, man. Yeah. Oh, and he sort of defended him by saying, oh, you know, it wouldn't be Jordan Lewis, you know, if he didn't do that sort of shit. It's like, dude, you clubbed the guy in the face.
Yeah.
And they tried to play up.
Footy classified, God
damn
it.
Who hit Rowe? Who was it that hit Rowe?
Hogan. You got 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And Hogan, they found him smoking
in
Perth.
Yeah.
What, can't smoke?
Oh, no, they just said it's not a good look, and it's like, well, he can do what he wants.
Wait, what do you mean he was caught smoking?
He went to Perth to see his family and stuff, and he was at a music festival, and he was smoking.
Was it a diary?
No, just a diary.
Okay, that's a big deal. It was not out of smoke.
They were just saying, oh, it's not a good look. It's like, well...
No, fuck off. It's bullshit. You can catch the footballers at the pub.
Dude, they're on it, mate. They're on it, mate.
Yeah, what the fuck? You made that a rule up. Yeah. I'll bat for Jesse Hogan here. Like, get fucked.
Yeah, who cares?
Remember Warnie when he got done smoking the durries when he got in that massive I quit smoking
debate
in the Coretta, whatever the fuck it was?
Got back on the durries, mate.
Fucking Bogan, man. As a win, just that's...
Fuck yeah!
No, but anyway... Carlton, man, a lot of good things to look forward to, man.
Well, look, our young...
The premiership this year.
No. Obviously. No, what did I tell you?
Obviously. Like, is it, all right. But Bobby's odds.
Bobby's know? Prediction.
He's got his
odds. That's not right.
He's got his little crystal ball here.
Mystic Bobby's predictions.
Mystic Polly.
More wearing a babushka.
Mystic Bobby.
Just on the cloak and dagger around.
I see blue. 2017 blue.
Well, think about some of our young guys, man.
Hey, I called it at the start of this year, Carlton, for the premiers.
Nah, man. Did we come and beat Richmond?
Just you're a fucking idiot.
Just took a couple of games to get going. No, we're all right. It's all right.
Did we can't beat Richmond. We're not going to be
or Melbourne.
Or Melbourne. Melbourne. We should have beaten Melbourne. We should have fucking beaten them.
We had them.
We had them, mate. We should have been 2-1. We should have been 2-1.
I love we only do footy talk when Carlton wins. So funny.
Because fuck everyone else.
I'll be honest. You know, I wasn't even going to bring up Carlton. I just remembered it because we actually haven't talked about Carlton at all. Like, period. Because I haven't seen you at work. I haven't seen this guy at work at all, man. When was the last time I saw you?
I'm the ghost who walks at work, aren't I?
Seriously?
Ghost who sleeps.
Ghost who jerks.
The ghost who jerks.
The ghost who wanks. The ghost who wanks.
The ghost who flogs.
Just one cubicle of Danny's just the door's always locked.
And no way! It's got his name on there, Bobby.
Call Bobby for a fun time.
Fun Bobby!
You know what? I'm going to graffiti your name inside the men's toilets at work.
And right. guess which one?
That's fine.
He goes into every stall. Bobby, what are you doing?
Honestly, I haven't seen him at all. I was just going to say, the first thing I wanted to bring up about the footy was Gary Ablett. Did you see what he did?
It deactivated all social media stuff and...
Yeah. And then came out and destroyed fucking... Who was it that he blitzed?
Hawthorne.
Smashed him by like 90 points.
Yeah. Did you see what his stats were?
36 posies.
Stats.
No, I know exactly what he had.
Yeah,
he had 36 posies. He had something ridiculous clearances.
Like four tackles.
Couple of goals.
Yeah, 2 goals, 1.
Two goals, 1. Really? Okay, think about it, right?
I'm the stats.
The week before...
Let me check that.
Do you know why? Because I saw the result, and I went, what the fuck?
So
the first thing I did was pull out the stats, and I just went, Ablett, like, just killed it. And what pissed me off was the week before, the papers were all coming out saying, oh, he's done, past his prime, he's not motivated, he wants to leave Gold Coast, it's a joke, like he's making a mockery of the contract.
Dude, you can't have one bad game with this media. Dude, they're all over you.
He's 36 and 2 goals, 1.
He was at Geelong and broke records. Went to Gold Coast to start a new team, set records on his own. Has one bad game after like spending a whole season injured.
And they jump on him like he's done.
Yeah. Can I just say though, Gold Coast have been really unlucky, man. Like, you know how many injuries they had last year?
Yeah, they were fucked.
They were decimated, man. Like no shit.
They were like Carlton like 3 years ago. Yeah.
Like, if any team copped that amount of injuries, say Geelong.
Yeah.
Say Selwood was taken out, Hawkins,
Paddy,
Paddy and some other randoms.
See you later.
Mate, your team's fucked.
Yeah, if you've got no stock in the fucking stable, you're fucked.
Their forward line, like Tom Lynch, the kid's going to be a monster. He's their captain now.
Mm-hmm.
That kid, he reminds me of a young Fev, just like able to do shit when you're looking at him going, God damn.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. But that's the thing. Like, the first thing I did was look up his stats. I'm like, how is that a bad game? Yeah, that's like a brilliant game for anyone else. Yeah. Anyone else, that's like you're in the club's history book for the rest of your life.
I only had 30 possessions. What a hack of a game.
Yeah, what a hack.
Yeah.
Like we're talking about Harvey.
Yeah.
When he retired, it's like Harvey would be the best player at any other club.
Dude, he was their leading goal kicker.
Yeah.
And then he got the list. He was a midfielder.
The aging midfielder was their leading goal kicker.
He outkicked old man Wade.
Yeah.
Probably their fastest runner as well.
Yeah.
Dude. At 36.
At 36.
Yeah. That's what I was just saying, man. Like, ridiculous.
But can I just say the Blue Boys? Like, our young crop that we've got, and the young crop leading that crop is Doherty, man. We've got McCready, Plowman. What a kid, man. Marchbank from GWS. How good's he been? We've got Williamson. Yep. On the weekend, it was his first game, and he was laying tackles left, right, centre, man.
Yep.
Can I just say one more thing, though? Murphy, fucking what a game, man.
Oh,
stood up as a captain.
Goal of the year to me.
Mate, that goal that he kicked from the boundary.
He was leading everything. He led everything.
Dude,
touches, tackles, like everything.
And one was, like, Bolton came out saying Murphy's really stepped up as captain, but his 3 games this year have been great. Honestly been great. But against the Bombers, he fucking lifted and he said, there's no better thing than being the Bombers. He actually came out and said it.
My boy Murphy.
Yeah. Yes. In other words, go fuck yourselves.
I don't know. I reckon it's going to be an interesting year of footy, man.
Look, I reckon we're not going to make finals.
Nah, no way.
But if we can get maybe...
Mystic Bobby says otherwise.
You think we're going to win the flag?
Exactly.
if we can win, well, last year we won 7 games. If we can win around the same, yeah, I'd say it's been a good year because we've shifted 14 players from last year again.
14?
14, man.
14?
Yeah, we got rid of a lot of dead wood, man. Cameron Wood.
Mind the pun on that one.
Cameron Wood.
And some other hacks.
We shifted dead wood. Like Cameron Wood?
Like Dale Fraser. Like who Cameron the fuck Wood. Is that?
Who's you Fraser? Know?
Exactly. Like, it was some kid that played for the Northern Blues. A lot of kids, you know, like, dude.
The mate senior squad.
Think about it. Tui left. Henderson, obviously, went to
Geelong. What's he doing over there? I haven't seen
him. Mate, he's been doing really good.
Yeah?
Man. Yeah.
Is Henderson still alive?
I haven't seen him.
Poor Hendo.
Maybe he's suckling on his mother's teat.
No.
Fuck Henderson. Poor, I'm looking at you, Bobby, because you love that guy.
Poor Lucky.
Leave Lucky alone.
Leave Lucky alone! Poor Lucky.
You know who I wanted to bring up? Do you watch the Freo game?
Yeah.
Fucking incredible. Like, they were on the back foot. The other cunts were on the back foot the entire game.
Fremantle have been done for the last year and a half, and they come out and play like that.
Yeah.
Like,
I was going to put money on them as well, and I did it.
I was going to as well. The last second, I'm like, I should put $5
but on it's
this.
Freo.
It's funny.
But and it's Freo.
I'm an idiot. Like, I should have done it. I'm a dumb cunt.
Yeah, but it's Freo, so you don't know who's going
to... I've got a question to ask.
Yeah?
Has Sandlin's been injured, like, for an exuberant amount of time?
Yeah,
How many seasons do you reckon he's missed?
Well, he missed last year and a bit of the year before. He got something about his sternum or some shit. He got kneed in the chest.
Fuck?
Yeah, man.
Took a tiger knee to the chest.
Yeah, and it full, like, broke his... it was all fucked up.
Serious? He's also had turf toe a couple of times.
He has.
What's turf toe?
Sore toe.
Yeah, but for a big guy like that...
What's turf toe?
Like, when you got a guy that big playing AFL, you're just going to have problems. Like, he's...
As in, just his toe's fucked. Just... Like, it's just fucked up. And
the reason why I'm asking is because...
Just his 12-inch toe gets in the way every now and then. It gets bent back.
You're fucked. 12-inch toe?
His talon.
No, he has to roll it up and tuck it in when he plays.
Yeah, totally.
Into his shoe.
Man, that guy is a giant. He is a giant.
Yeah. The reason I was asking was, I was watching the game, and they're like, oh, he's 250th, or I think that's what it was, 250th game, or somewhere there.
We get up his stats.
And I just said, 250th? The guy's been playing since, like, 93. How's he only got to
since 93?
Seriously.
He's been around.
He's been around forever, man. Like, literally, he's been around forever. Has he only got 250 games? Fletcher managed to roll out 400.
Tell you what, he got recruited. I tell you, he was a fucking rookie.
He didn't get in 89.
89? Freo wasn't even a team.
They got to the Hawks, you know, like in their premiership year.
Freo in 89.
He's only 2 years older than us.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
He's 34. Like, he's about 40.
He does. He looks like he's 50, man.
He looks fucked.
That's what I said.
And you know what's funny? His picture is of 2006 with Whittle in his wiki page.
Jesus. Battling Oz and Landwin. Oh, yeah. Look how big he is.
Do you know why? Because when I was watching the game on Sunday, I was half asleep on my couch. I just did a full shift at work. I had like 4 hours sleep. I was fucked. So I literally just like sat down, like
zoned out.
Yeah, just finished cooking. I'm like, oh, the footy's on. So I caught the game just as it was starting. And I'm just sitting there like half asleep. And then the commentators are saying something like, oh, yeah, it's 250th game to Adam Sandlin's. I'm like, 250?
What, what?
Yeah, what? Like, the guy that's been playing since the fucking 70s.
It's the 40s. He's bailing out with, like, Kevin Bartlett and shit.
Did they already have a statue with him with, like, Dwyer down at Richmond?
Oh, fuck. Seriously? So he's gone from, like, the 90s down to the 70s to the 40s.
So when did he get recruited? For real?
Pick 33 in the 2002 rookie draft.
2002. So 15 years.
Oh yeah, he is
been right. Plagued with injury. The poor fella.
He's 211 centimeters, which equates to 6'11", and he weighs
6'11".
Yeah, man. And he weighs 100.
That's why he's so much bigger than everyone.
Dude, and he weighs 120 kilos.
Giant.
He's just a unit, man.
How big is Buddy?
He doesn't move very well.
I'll just tell you something, Sandlin's, but he gets on the bongs, man.
Oh.
Dude.
Stoner for
sure. He looks
like
a creep.
Dude, how are you? Yeah, he gets on the bongs.
Dude, he looks like
him and Matthew
like,
Cruiser smoke bongs together.
Oh, man. He looks like Robert from Everybody Loves Raymond.
Robert. Oh, he does.
He does. I'm serious.
Dude, he just looks like a stoner. I'm telling you, man.
He's only 2 years older than us.
Yeah, he looks like
chances are he is a stoner, man.
Probably is. And he's from Fremantle, so.
Yeah. You're throwing the West under the bus.
Down by the docks, mate.
Oh, man. Come
smoking
on.
Cones by the ships.
They love it down in Perth.
Oh, the Westerlies coming in, boys.
Yeah.
Down the ships, so they get all their drugs.
Yep, down at the docks.
Yeah.
Dockers.
Who's his wife?
Speaking of dockers, man.
Jenny Hofsink.
6'12"
Speaking of docks, I saw a news report earlier this week. There was a major celebrity down at, you know, the movie studios just around the corner at the Docklands. There's like three sets. They were reporting like a Hollywood celebrity down at the docks. So I'm like,
he wasn't Toady.
No, what?
Toady.
No. He's America's Toady.
America's Toady. Let me think about this.
It's just the most random celebrity you've ever thought of. Like, random actor. Actually, he's from a family of actors. He's got siblings. Actually, one of them passed away earlier this last year as well. Or maybe it was early this year. Yeah. I don't know why. I actually didn't think of it last time.
It's Toady.
No, he's just got that face.
Yeah.
He's been around forever. Actually, I can think of like a...
Is he a child actor?
We've referenced a movie that he was in not long ago. And, how else have we referenced him? We've referenced him like twice without thinking.
Is he a child actor?
I don't think he was a child actor.
Mm-hmm.
But when I saw the news thing, he came out looking stoned as fuck. But his expression was like, "I can't believe I'm actually in Melbourne, like of all places." Like,
Zach Galifianakis?
What the fuck? No,
get me out of this shit.
Yeah, yeah, literally like, oh yeah, cool. Like, this is great. Like that's how it was.
I love Melbourne.
Yeah, and I was just watching him. Like, dude, you're fucked.
What's his name?
David Arquette.
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, we referenced. He was in fucking
Scream.
No, the Adam Sandler movie. Airheads.
Dude, his claim to fame.
He's a stoner in Airheads. He's a stoner in Airheads.
So many circles.
Dude, his claim to fame would be marrying Courtney Cox.
And Scream.
I don't remember him. I never saw Scream.
Officer Doofy.
I've never seen. I've never seen Scream, like from start to finish. Never.
Oh, dude, he just looks like he gets on the bongs, man.
David Arquette.
Oh, dude, he looks ruined, man. He's just.
Yeah, man, he's in Melbourne. But he's got, like, he's from a family of things, like Patricia Arquette, and then the drag queen one.
Yeah, yeah, she passed away.
What was her name?
The drag queen one.
Yeah, yeah, I keep forgetting her fucking name. She was in The Wedding Singer.
Yeah. Do you really want to hurt me?
Yeah.
You mean Boy George?
The Boy George
Alexis.
One. Alexis Arquette, yeah.
Okay.
She passed away.
Oh.
When was it?
Oh my.
A month ago? 2 months ago?
September 11, 2016.
Oh, it was last year. Okay. Huh.
I actually heard on the radio, it's like...
Cardiac arrest caused by HIV.
Yeah.
Surprise, surprise.
Seriously.
I heard on the radio, it was like...
You're a cunt, man.
A month away until, like, Prince's death.
Yeah. Lenny Kravitz sang... Did you see Lenny Kravitz sing...
It's been a year.
It's been nearly a year.
Are you joking?
I tripped out. It was on the way here, and I was like, what?
It's been a year.
It felt like a couple of months ago
to
me.
I remember the day Prince died.
I remember talking about it.
I remember. Do you know why? Because I remember waking up. I got up to have breakfast because I was getting ready for work.
Dude, April 21st, 2016.
Jesus.
Dude, what the fuck?
Man, I specifically remember that morning because I got up to have cereal, just sitting at my kitchen table in cereal. And I got the phone out and there were all these Prince photos on Instagram. And I'm like, what the fuck? And then I'm like, someone said, you know, rest in peace, something. I'm like, what? So I looked up breaking news and I saw it. I was like just stunned. I got to work. Fabiani was there and Fabiani's like a big Prince fan.
Mm-hmm.
Me and him like have always just sung random songs. I've walked in. He just looked at me. He's like, what the fuck? I go, man, like what the fuck? A week earlier, I'd sent Fabiani like a random picture of Prince, like just some random photo of him. And like, he's like, man, what a sick cunt. Like, yeah, bad. And bang, goes like
weak
2 weeks later. Yeah.
But a year.
Yeah. Same thing happened with George Michael. I sent Fabiani a picture of George Michael, and then, like, a week and a half later, like, George Michael cocked it.
All right, don't send Fabiani any more pictures of celebrities that you like.
I sent him another message saying, you better tell Paul Stanley to start eating his fucking vitamins before he goes as well, man.
Please don't send Fabiani any pictures of me, all right?
Nah. we trade out, like, whatever we have, like, every day.
Like, April 21st, man.
I can't believe it's been a year.
Yeah, it feels like just, like, a couple of months ago. It really does.
Purple rain.
When doves cry. That was
his only song.
That was his only good song. When doves cry.
Okay, I'm gonna fucking
Little Red COVID. You don't know those songs? Dude, what is wrong with you?
Erotic City, man.
Dude, like what is wrong with you?
This is
I love it. He also wrote off Alice Cooper.
Oh, that was a fucking curtain call.
Oh, his only good song is Poison. Like, that's the most mainstream Alice Cooper song.
Beat my Frankenstein.
Not good.
I'm going to stab you with my pen, man. I say, launch over this table.
It's just, yeah. Fuck you guys, Raging Control.
I love a Metallica t-shirt. Ride the lightning. He's wearing a Metallica t-shirt. And he's arguing about Alice Cooper and Prince. Dude, are you serious? You don't know Prince's catalogue?
Not really, man. We've talked about this. I was never.
People have asked me, man, like, who's your most respected musician, artist, whatever. It's like, you know what? I don't know his entire catalog, but Prince goes down as one of the best music artists, producers, whatever you want to call him, man. Like, genius. And fucking Doves Cry, yeah, it was a good song. It wasn't his best song.
Why is his only good one?
Dude, Doves Cry, no chance.
Nah, man.
I love trolling you.
Do you know what his best song was? Head. The song Head.
I get head.
Nah.
Dude.
Do you know what the song Head's about? It's
you know what? Nah. You know he was the ultimate pimp? You know why? You know what this song's called? Pussy Control.
Controls that pussy.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Let me guess how it goes.
That I crane. Got
pussy control. Oh, yeah.
Wait for it. Wait
I got
for
the
it.
Pussy under control, yeah.
Presentación especial comenzará en breve. Pero antes, un mensaje de nuestros auspiciados.
This guy fucked anything, man.
That reminds me of that Sash song. Remember Sash?
Oh, yeah.
Sash. Or ATV, am I thinking?
I saw Sash live.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Got the pussy control. Yeah. Good morning,
ladies and gentlemen, boys and motherfucking girls. This is your captain with no name speaking, and I'm here to rock your world with a
Prince man. Prince man.
I got a woman you already know. No prostitute, she but the mayor of your brain. Pussy control.
What about the song Cream?
Get on top.
Cream.
That was his other okay song. No, I'm trolling you boys.
Prince is a massive J-dub as well. He stopped performing all those songs because of his religious beliefs. Did you know that?
The J-dub.
A bit late.
No,
it was a J-dub. You know,
I'm serious.
Yeah, I knew that.
Yeah.
So
was Michael Jackson, apparently.
Yeah, he was.
We used to wear a fat suit when he went witnessing.
Yeah, yeah. They're both. It's funny because Prince and Michael Jackson had, like, that ongoing rivalry. Like, it was an unofficial rivalry. It was getting played up mostly by media. Just
and they both had the...
Yeah, but you know what? They're both different artists, though, man. Yeah. You can't compare them.
And they both like thrusting
Prince
their crutches.
Prince was overtly sexual and nothing stood
in his
way.
Oh, he just slayed box,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, like nothing stood in his way.
He did!
Slayed a box.
Artistically, Prince had no boundaries, man. He was just an artist.
Pussy control, man.
Michael Jackson made progressive shit, but it was still pop. It was very pop-driven. Yeah. Where Prince didn't care about pop. He just made fucking raw shit. You know what I mean? Totally different artists. Prince wasn't a dancer the way Michael Jackson was, and Michael Jackson wasn't a musical innovator the way Prince was. You know what I mean? Apples and oranges, you can't compare them.
But some cream.
The song Head,
Michael was more just like an icon, wasn't he?
They're both icons. They're both icons, but just to different audiences. You know, like, there weren't any four-year-old girls singing Prince songs, because they didn't fucking get it.
Yeah, yeah. Michael was put out there in front of...
Yeah, like, exactly. Where Prince just sort of went under the radar and just started making massive tunes.
Hence why I was a huge Michael Jackson fan. Also, yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah. Like, my parents had Michael Jackson records. They didn't have Prince records. I had to get my Prince records from, like, my god sister or, like, just random, like, you know, cousins and stuff, you know. But Prince, what a sick cunt.
What a mad dog.
Let me clarify. The song Head.
I get head.
It's not even like
that. Why does every song start?
Is that how it went?
Oh, my God.
Nah, tell me. What?
No. The song Head is about he meets this girl, right, who's on the way to get married. Right? And she's saying how she's a virgin.
I'm coming up with some loose.
She's saying that she's a virgin. So she can't get fucked, but she wants to give him head. Or he'll give her head. Like, she's on the way to church to get married. And he's like, nah.
Dude, can't you tell
you? Detour.
Prince.
Detour.
Yeah.
We're doing this.
Prince is the original R. Kelly, man.
Yeah. He is.
Yeah.
The Prince deviant. Was singing R. Kelly songs before R. Kelly.
Yeah, he was a JW. Something doesn't add up here.
Yeah, well, he stopped all that shit, and then, yeah, when he found Jesus...
Cleaned himself up.
Yeah, pretty much.
When he found Jar.
He stopped performing, like, all the overtly sexual songs at his concerts, man. I think I heard a few of them as a medley when I went and saw him, but I don't remember anything else past that.
I went to, from I Get Head to God Is My Head.
You're fucked.
Your fault.
Re-release of Head.
What? The man's been dead a year, man.
Mate, the saviour's head.
You're both fucked. We're the most blasphemous, like, podcast we've ever done in our lives. We're going to lose so many fucking listeners right now.
And we're all going to hell.
I'm already going to hell.
I said to someone the other day, I know exactly where I'm going. if there is an afterlife. There's no, because someone said to me, aren't you going to do this? Aren't you going to do that? Like for Easter, in the spirit of Easter, I laughed. That's not going to save me. Are you joking? What? And that's what I don't understand. How you can do whatever you can do whatever the fuck you want, but as long as you go to confession, take communion,
you'll be sweet.
You're sweet. Then what is this like dog and pony show, man?
Like before you get into the church, you just kick the shit out of someone, right? Just bloody them. Do whatever you want. Church. I'm sorry, I just kicked the shit out of someone.
My bad, priesty.
You're forgiven, my son. Okay. Dude, you walk out with bleeding fists. You know?
There's so many different rules in regards to church. Like, you know what gets me, right? Attire. Church attire.
Yeah.
Yeah? Where they're like, you need to be dressed up like in your shit.
Yes.
To go into church. It's like,
you still loathe that.
What if you can only afford rags? You're not allowed to go to church. You're going to be looked down
on. That's right.
Aren't they meant to help the fucking people? Like, do you know what I mean?
Did you wear your little suit?
You know one thing I always used to think about? In all our literature, like all the Bible characters, like all the apostles and Jesus, they all had beards, right?
Apostle Bobby.
But you weren't allowed to have a beard. You had to be clean cut. Like, you had to be.
Who said this? Oh, you're talking about it's in J-Dub?
Yeah.
You can't have a beard if you're a J-Dub?
No.
Really? I didn't know that.
No.
Prince had a beard.
I'm talking about Prince being a saviour.
What about Prince?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
But it used to confuse me when I was younger because it was like a big frown upon to have a beard. You had to be super clean cut, like no long hair, no beard, nothing.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about all the J-Dubs I know. They're all clean cut. Yeah.
In all our literature, every single character in the literature had beards and long hair.
And
I'd always scratch my head like, what?
I said to you, I made that joke at Christmas time and my auntie and my mum, like my mum was laughing and my auntie was like sort of horrified. I said, Jesus wore sandals. Why do we have to wear fucking like, you know, suits?
Polished leather.
Yeah, polished leather. Jesus wore sandals and a fucking sarong thing,
the white dress,
tunic cloak thing.
Mm. Why can't I walk into church like that?
Yeah, dude, women.
I'm being like Jesus.
Women cannot take Holy Communion if they've got their period. If they're menstruating.
Mm-hmm.
So for four to five days of the fucking month, if you happen to land on that, you can't go to a church because you're considered unclean.
In Orthodox
Who the fuck
church,
decided that
you can't wear pants if you're a woman.
Yeah, who decided? That women can't go to church because
what? Church upskirts,
dude. That's the worst thing. You're a terrible, terrible person. That is the worst thing that's ever been said. Yeah,
my man.
Bobby's on board.
I love how we've waited to good like Easter week to just come up with the most fucking vile shit ever.
Fuck yeah, that's right? Mad.
No, but seriously, think about it. Yeah. If God created the human. Body reproduction system, blah blah blah.
Yeah.
Then why would he curse women with a period to not allow them to take communion?
Something that he gave them.
Yeah, and not allow them to take communion during Easter week. What man decided this?
Well, it's funny you say that. I remember reading in the Bible back in the day, and I used to just trip out about it. Like it's this huge long thing, like a passage. It's just all about how women are unclean when they're on their period. It just basically,
but yeah, they're the birth givers. They're the ones that bring life into this world.
Yeah.
But they're unclean.
They are literally just the essence of like
she will be unclean from this day. It just goes on and on, just saying how unclean they are.
Degrading women.
I used to trip out on it, man. I feel like, what is going on here?
Then Johnny would go at the back and slap his missus.
You unclean bitch.
Filthy bitch.
Clean yourself up.
It's all you hear in the background. Johnny, you're right, comes in with a rag. Clean yourself up.
The funny part is, like, it's just him getting the shit kicked out of him. Some random, like, it tries to front up.
Some random bird
slaps him and sends him flying. He's in his flannel and PJs.
Like a church comes in, adjusts his tie. He's got like a red cheek. Does his hair again. Like, oh, I'm good. Yeah. Johnny,
I don't know.
I'm good.
You know what? Do you reckon it's fucked that we talk about religion this much?
Someone's got to talk about it.
Hang on. Do you think we talk about religion a lot? Or do you think... Because we don't. We don't really. Like,
well, we were talking about fairy tales before. It wasn't like... Well, it just comes up.
It's not like every episode we're banging on religion. It's just like every now and then it comes up.
It kind of is.
I think it's lately because of the intolerance that people are showing towards, like, say, Islam.
It is Easter week.
So it is Easter week, so it's in our faces.
Yeah.
So guaranteed this was going to be a religious episode. But I think it's because of all the intolerance. That's why we keep talking about it. Because no one else is fucking talking about the intolerance.
Greg got Prince, religion, like...
But also, like,
this is being slapped by a menstruating woman.
R. Kelly.
She's already angry.
R. Kelly. R. Kelly. I'm getting pissy on him.
The whipping boy, man.
Jesus Christ.
Copping a
sin. Jesus Christ whipping R. Kelly, man.
Jesus.
Also, a lot late. I lost my
We've gone to shit. We've gone to shit,
whoa,
boys.
Whoa, seriously.
No, like, another thing that brings up religion for us in a group is, like, all, like, you know, the recent transhumanist stuff and, like, all that sort of stuff.
Oh, like, as in, like, gender alignment and stuff?
Yeah, and they're talking about, you know, like, rich men playing God as far as, like, putting chips in people and stuff like that. Like, that brings up the whole God debate, so that...
Oh,
you
know, okay, what I mean? Yeah.
And we're into all that sort of stuff, so it's something that we're constantly always thinking about as a group.
Do you reckon everyone else is, like, do you reckon the guys, like, we work with or, like, people we know, do you reckon they're having these conversations?
Maybe. Some might.
I don't know.
A handful.
Because, I honestly, man, I don't spend that much time talking about religion with too many other people. I'm being serious.
I don't talk about religion at all, except with you guys.
Yeah.
As in, I don't really...
I discuss it, like, if something's come up, but not necessarily because we raise it as...
It's not on the top of your list.
Yeah.
You sit there and talk about it.
Generally, when I bring up religion with anyone at work, I'm like, ah, fucking fuck that. That's pretty much it.
We work with a lot of bogans,
conversation
though.
Over.
Yeah, we work with a lot of bogans, though.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So they're, like, what's it called? Attention span for that sort of shit. Like, they've got no interest in it, so what do they give a fuck? You know what I have interest in? Man, the last, like, 2 days... I've been getting a lot of new, South Asian Bollywood songs and, like, just shit like that. Like, just updating the music list, you know, like, I got the new Big Sean album, and then Sam the Afghan sent me a whole bunch of new songs, so I sent him a whole bunch back, and then last night I had 45 minutes to myself, so I just fucking updated the iPod, and I actually sent him a message. I was driving here, and he was texting me something random, and I'm like, man, this is fucked. I go, I'm driving along, I'm going to a recording session, and I'm listening to Tasha Ta, Arjun, Ajit Singh, and, like, Zach Knight, and, like, some other dude. I'm fucking Greek. I don't even remember, like, the last time I listened to a Greek song, but I'm literally just naming all these Indian artists and shit like that. Anyone that doubts the power, like, anyone that wants to ever dismiss the Bollywood scene, like, as in, like, oh, it's rubbish culture, blah, 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 like, no one gives a fuck.
I'm dismissing it right now.
Dude. I was looking up a song, and it's this singer, Arjun.
Sway me.
Dude, this singer, Arjun, right, is, he's Tamil Sri Lankan, yeah? And he's from the UK.
Bill Dibsonist.
I didn't even get to finish what I was saying. He's signed to one of, the biggest labels, yeah? And he does a lot of the same sort of songs, like a lot of blends and shit like that. His first song was a cover of, like, a famous Sri Lankan Tamil song, right? Like, everyone was covering it, so he did his own cover of it.
The Cobra Dance?
Came out... No.
You fucking ignorant
bogan. I'm going to find something.
Ignorant bogan.
I can't.
I'm being purposely ignorant. You know that.
Dude.
Taming the Cobra? Is that what we're talking about?
My God, let me finish. All right, I looked up the song last night. And then I looked up the original one. The original one had nearly 120 million views on YouTube.
Oh,
shit.
120 million views. Dude, like, seriously, can you name
it? But you have to take into account how many Indians there are.
Well, there's a lot.
Well, obviously, but I'm fucking listening to it.
He's not Indian.
I'm not Indian. No, we're near Indian.
Yeah, but all I'm saying is the majority of those players probably come from India.
Or South Asia.
Yeah, well, sorry,
generally,
yeah.
South Asia. Yeah. The Sri Lankan Tamils, man. So, they're, like, Tamil speakers all over the world.
Yeah, no, I didn't mean that. Yeah, South Asia.
What I'm listening for. I'm kind of sketchy. I don't know what he's teeing up right now. He looks kind of deviant. Look at him. Look at him.
It's the Cobra Dance.
Is that a remix?
What is it?
Literally a Cobra Dance.
I've heard this one.
He's got it at home.
He sits there and he gets in his pyjamas, but he snakes through the pyjamas. He's like...
Snake is my wang.
Why are we being so ignorant right now? You're just picturing Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
You know, like, it actually sounds pretty cool. It's got... If you hear, like, later on, you go through it, it's got the little things at the back.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Sitar, man.
Super cool.
But yeah, I was going through all that sort of shit, and then I started reading about classical languages. You know what I mean? Do you know how many classical languages there are across the world?
Classical.
Classical languages, like a list of classical languages. Literally. Basically...
I'm a little confused as to what you mean.
Okay. I was reading about, like, first... Because I was reading about him, and then I was reading about... Because the song's in Tamil. So I was reading more about Tamil. And Tamil is, like, yeah, Sri Lankans speak Tamil. Obviously, in India, there's, like, a big portion of Tamil speakers. yada, 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 depending where you're from. India alone has got like over 25, 30 languages, like in India.
Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
You don't speak Chinese. Like we've said before, you speak Cantonese or Mandarin, Indo-Malay. You go to India and you speak either Tamil or Telugu or Hindi or Punjab or like a million fucking, dialects, classical languages across the world. And this is what, I think it was in the midst of all the fucking Pauline Hanson crap, because I got just frustrated with her stupid face because she didn't even know what non-halal certified food was. Do you know what I mean? Like, she was making a stand against halal certification by eating Lindt chocolate or Daryl Lee because it's not... It's like, you're a fucking idiot. Muslims can still eat this. Like, she had no idea what she was protecting. Like that's her naive little stance. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm doing the most Aussie thing ever. Like, you're a fucking moron, right? So I was reading about all this sort of shit. I looked further into it. Basically, classical languages are what... They all the main ones, everything that stems from everything else, right? Mm-hmm. So if you look at the historically, there are five languages that have had overwhelming significance as carriers of culture. Okay, so
English, number one, English at the top of the list
because that was the first language that ever existed.
Anglo English.
Look at this way. This is what this I was reading this thing on the net. Yeah. this guy from Berkeley, right, from the University of Berkeley, just some linguist, George L. Hart, this is what he said. I'll read the whole quote, but the bottom of the quote
One of Johnny's boys.
The five classical languages are classical Chinese, Sanskrit, Arabic, Greek, and Latin. In comparison with these, even such culturally important languages as Hebrew and French sink into secondary position, whether they like it or not. So when you look at the whole thing, his whole quote, it basically says... when we realize that an educated Japanese can hardly frame a single literary sentence without the use of Chinese resources, that to this day Siamese and Burmese and Cambodian bear the unmistakable imprint of Sanskrit and Pali that came in with Hindu Buddhism centuries ago. Or that whether we argue for or against the teaching of Latin and Greek, like in schools, our argument is sure to be studded with words that have come to us from Roman Athens. We get some indication of what early Chinese culture, Buddhism, classical Mediterranean civilization have meant in the world's history.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you take, you can argue, we shouldn't be teaching Greek or Latin,
But that's where it stems from.
Dude.
Yeah.
In essence, you're speaking Greek right now.
Yeah, I remember my dad used to teach me, like, all the correlations to the Greek language from English. Like, you can put it together.
Give me a word. Give me a letter. Any letter. Give me a word.
Like, octo. Octopus, just shit like that. Like,
all sorts of stuff. And it's amazing, like, when you look at, like, say, Sanskrit, and then, like, how far, like, the languages... Like, for me, that's, like, one thing for me is languages. I love languages. I love the way people communicate.
I find that super fascinating.
Oh, dude, it's amazing.
Yeah,
the way communication has just changed across the board.
Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you a question. What are your standard apps on your phone, like, right now, like, as in your screensaver? As in, not your screensaver, your home screen.
My home screen?
Yeah. I utilize my home screen space, man.
All right, so I've got Dream League Soccer. I've got SoundCloud. I've got my banking app. I've got SEN. And I've got Uber Eats and ASOS and realset.com and domain.
I think that's going to be a really nice window into it. But what's your home screen?
The actual home screen.
What's your photo? What's your wallpaper?
Mrs. I've got the Angel of Death.
I've got dicks from around the world.
Box or not.
Conspiracy hour.
Rate my poo.
How long is your dong? No. I have a calendar.
Okay.
WhatsApp. Pulse, which is...
You only got that because of me.
Yeah. Pulse, which is the counter for our podcast listens.
Oh, yeah, I've got that too. Yeah.
And then Productivity, which has phone and messages.
But that comes standard in your phone.
Yeah, but I moved onto my screen.
Is that what you've got on your home screen? Literally four icons.
Four icons and then the big That's Not Right logo.
And iTunes.
Loud and proud, center stage,
Safari,
Jimmy.
Safari, iTunes, and your Texas.
They're standard. I can't move them.
Yeah.
Sorry. And GarageBand.
Are you serious?
Yeah, you can play music on your phone.
Amazing. Every other company has had that for like 20 years, but Apple need to crack the phone or just like MP3s.
Always.
That's so fun. Dude, I utilize my space.
What the fuck is that?
The grind,
man.
Look at how many fucking apps I've got, like just on the home screen. Like two layers of fucking apps. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I've always utilized the space. I've got like a volume control thing, Shazam, Maps, Calculator, a music app, my recipes, like all my cooking recipes on tap, because I'd be at work or want to go do shopping. I'd be like, fuck, what do I need to cook? Oh, yeah, that. That's got that in it. I keep forgetting. Calendar, get this now, right? Insta, you know, WhatsApps, social media, like YouTube, whatever, eBay. I've got a news app, a memo app, Wikipedia, and then I've got the Pulse, the SoundCloud reader, two banking apps, our page manager for Facey, camera settings, yada, 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 yada. Yeah? Oh, and these are the ones that I want to highlight. I've got a dictionary app and I've got a translator app for like languages. They've been standard on my phone for over 10 years. I always have Wikipedia, the dictionary app, and the translator app. Because, man, any fucking random day, like I keep talking about Luis and the Chilean dude at work. We always talk Spanish. So I want to say something new in Spanish. I fucking translate it. Mm. Like that's my go-to in my head. I always want to be able to do that.
Yeah.
And so for me, like communication, languages across the world, forms of communication, methods, like all that shit, man, it's unbelievable. Like, you imagine the first people that would have landed just talking to each other and the evolution of languages to the point where you'd go from, like, you know, Northern Greece. Yeah. Do you remember Gladiator, the movie?
Yeah, Gladiator, yeah.
Yeah. Do you remember the opening scene where the Romans are charging the hill?
Yes.
Yeah.
Coming to the villages.
And they're fighting the Germanic tribes. And they're just screaming like Germanic Ostrogoth.
Yes.
Like really, really harsh.
Yeah.
You know? They're Germanic tribes, but they don't sound German. Yeah, they sound like some fucked up, you know, Ostrogoth language. Northern...
Barbaric.
Yeah, barbaric language. Because if you weren't educated in ancient Greek and Latin, you were considered a barbarian. Like, everything outside those borders. And that's why...
Barbarian. Do you know where that comes from? I heard this on a podcast once.
Varvaro, man. Greek.
A little bit of knowledge.
The word is varvaro in Greek.
Yeah, but do you know, like, why it's, like, barbarian?
Tell me.
Was it Conan?
Because if, like, barbarians that were coming, right, like, they'd just say, like, they're just speaking, like, blah, 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 like, say, yeah. Barbarian.
Like the Berbers, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard that on a podcast once. I was like, wow.
Yeah, man. Because anyone outside of the borders of, like, educated, if you weren't, you know...
You're just talking babble.
Yeah, you're just not... You're just lower dregs.
Yeah.
You know, uncivilized, just random, primitive, you know what I mean?
Yep.
And that's what trips me out when you look at how far languages have traveled. You know what I mean? Like, when you see, like, because of religion and different... Like, a lot of people don't understand, like, with Indians, you know, there are Hindus, there are fucking a lot of Muslims, and through that, like, you start bleeding, like, cultures, you know what I mean? Like, Middle Easterns are traditionally... Like, not traditionally, but there's a lot of Islam in the Middle East. But then as you bleed into the borders, whether you head into Africa or you head into South Asia, you have Islam taking over there. Not taking over, but a presence.
Yeah.
So then you start having cultures mixing their languages and their names. Like, dude, the Indian guy that I used to work with, his name was Yusuf. Dude, Yusuf is like an Israeli Judeo name.
Yeah.
Yusuf, you know, Joseph. Yeah. But he was Muslim and he was Indian.
Yeah.
Like, does that make sense?
Yeah, weird mix. Yeah.
And then I think about the fact that he's living in Australia and his little girl is an Australian citizen. Straight off the bat, she's an Australian.
Shout out to Yusuf.
Yeah, do you know what I mean? Like, it's fucked up. And when I see...
It's really cool.
I start dissecting that, man, as far as, like, languages and, like, you know...
And then we've arrived at the most supreme language, English.
Supreme.
Supreme?
The most elite supreme
language. The easiest fucking language in the world, man. Literally just made to cater. Like, literally made to cater. There's no antiquity, dude.
Bloody barbarians.
Call.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, like, super interesting, man.
Yeah, it's fucked up. Yeah. I spend a lot of time reading about that shit, man. And I don't know.
It's like my old man speaks fluent Thai, as I've told you guys.
Which
before.
Which blows my fucking mind.
And when he speaks it, I just trip out. Like, I wish you had taught me this, motherfucker. But like, and he tells me, like, in Thai, it's so different to English. Like, they say everything reverse. Like,
I know.
Like, same peanut butter, like, would be butter peanut. Like, everything's so it's completely.
Well,
different.
We've got words like that where it's like we can't translate it.
You can't translate the actual meaning.
English,
yeah.
Spanish, dude, it's like a reverse negative, man. With Spanish, you always say. Okay. Like you said, what's a league? What's a Spanish league called? The cup?
La Liga.
Yeah, La Liga, right? And then the cup is called the Copa del Rey, King's Cup.
Copa del Rey, yeah.
Copa meaning cup, del Rey meaning the king, so the King's Cup.
Yeah.
Like, it's always a negative. Like, so if you want to say, Fuck yeah, I, like,
blow me.
Me, you will blow.
Yeah. If you want to say, like, I said to you in, like, the other podcast, right? If you want to say a warehouse full of donkeys, right? It's bodega de burro. Like, so you don't say the donkey's warehouse, you say the warehouse of donkeys.
Yeah.
It's always a negative. Like, yeah. If you say, fuck, I can't even think of an example. Like, I'm just drawing blanks.
Suck my wang.
Chinga tu madre.
Chinga tu madre.
Fuck your mother.
Yeah. Chinga tu madre.
Yeah. That's a good
at the best.
You know what's funny, man? I thought about it the other day, about a month or two ago, man. I was driving, because I was thinking about all this multicultural shit, because of all, everyone we work with, you know what I mean? Everyone's from everywhere.
The UN in there.
Yeah, it is. It literally is, man. There's everyone from everywhere. I was driving along one morning. I was on a fork, and I was trying to get... one of the aisles was backed up by two forkies talking. Like, they were parked on both sides of the aisle, and they were chatting.
Good luck.
And one guy's Turkish and one guy's Lebanese. As I pulled up, I screamed, "Adı Malaka," which means, like, hurry the fuck up, like, dickhead in Greek, right? And they ignored me. Like, they didn't hear me. So I screamed out at one, without even thinking, man, I screamed out at one. I went, "Hadi lan," which means, like, move it, man, like, in Turkish. And then I got that, "Yalla bub," which means, like, move, bro, like, in Arabic.
Yeah.
Before I actually screamed, "Cunts, can you move the fuck out of the way?"
Four languages.
Three languages before I got
to the point.
And then I moved. You know what I mean? And I thought, man, that's fucking cool. There was another one I did. This happened like only a couple of weeks ago. It made me laugh, man. Like, something like Arabs always say, right? Arabs say it, and it translates to Muslims as well, right? Something you always hear me say is inshallah, which means God willing, right? Arabs say it in a condescending way where, like, if a child is saying, "Oh, can we have ice cream? Inshallah." It's like, "Yeah, God willing," which means translate to no. Like, it's not going to happen. Like, yeah, maybe.
Yeah, see what happens.
If God allows it.
Like,
right?
A sarcastic almost.
Yeah, exactly. And I've said it to one of the Lebos at work a couple of times when he's, like, angry at someone, and I've said it. He just starts, like, the first time I said it to him, he sort of looked at me and he just started laughing because he realized, like, what I'd said. We're at work, and Ozzy the Turk. He was fucking around, like, we're moving some shit. And he
love
cracked
Aussie,
it.
Love Aussie.
Yeah, he's a great guy. He cracked it at someone because they were doing something stupid. And he said something like, "Oh, when the fuck are they going to sort this out? Or are they even going to fucking..." He said something like that. I just looked at him and went, "Inshallah." And he never heard me say it. He just died because he's Turkish, right? He's Muslim. And he fucking lost it. And he just kept laughing about it. He screamed it out at me, right? And I've just driven away, like, laughing, right? And then 10, 20 meters down the thing, I saw him talking from a distance. I saw him, like, just keeling over laughing, and then
telling the story.
One of the Afghan boys was like, looked at him, he's like, "Oh, what are you laughing about?" So I just said, "Inshallah," back to him. And the Afghan started laughing. Here's an Afghani guy and a Turkish guy from across the fucking pond laughing because a Greek guy said an Arabic word which translates to something in Muslim, which is a personal joke, and they both fucking got it, like, immediately. And then they both drove past me and they were just laughing.
And that's what makes Australia great.
Exactly.
Should make it great. And
exactly.
You got people like Pauline.
Exactly.
Fucking Hansen.
Exactly. He's
ruining
it. You know what I mean? He's a Turk, a Lebo, an Afghan and a Greek all sharing the same fucking joke in another language, which only one of them is like a native speaker of.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And all three guys were born overseas,
mm-hmm.
except for me.
Mm-hmm.
How fucked up is that?
It's cool.
I know, exactly. And that, like you said, that's why Australia is so fucking great, because we're allowed to have that.
Yeah.
Then you got Airbnb hosts not allowing
Asians
who have been in a country for 20 years as citizens.
Well, you've got this small group of people just, like, ruining it.
But she thinks, but that Airbnb hostess, man, thinks she has the power to say that because Trump's in power.
It's Trump.
And Trump is going to sort out foreigners the same way all the Bogans would support Pauline Hanson because they think that she's got the answers to, like, the migration. Well, it's not even an issue of migration, man.
All right, Pauline, lead him through the desert.
Good luck with that red hair and white skin.
Go on, Pauline.
She'd be the first one running for the hills.
Dude, man. They would eat her before...
She'll crisp up in the sun in 2 seconds.
Crackling anyone?
Can you just see her burning up? She's got no idea where to go.
It's a little warm out here.
Anyone brought water?
Can I get a drink?
Anyone got SPF?
Is that water non-halal?
You know what? Let's end it on
that's
that.
That's awesome.
Yeah, good idea, huh?
Non-halal water on Easter week.
Boom! Inshallah, everybody.
Inshallah. Akbar, man. God is cracked. Okay, that's not right. Wrapping up the Easter week podcast with Salah. Hello, Akbar.
Juke leverage out.